We are creating a precious keepsake as well as a one-of-a-kind piece of jewelry, and I'm talking about custom thumbprint pendants. Now, how could you not love this idea?
We're going to learn more about it today. Tricia Szasz with Parkville Artisans Studio joins us now to show us how to make our own. First off, happy 2019. Thank you for being here. We know you've been busy over there in Parkville.
I have.
Keeping downtown running and everything.
Always busy. And this is one of our newest popular classes.
Okay.
These little pendants are much easier than you think.
Good.
They're super fun. There are a couple of different ways you can do it. The way I chose was to use some Sculpey. This is stuff, it's like clay, but you bake it in your oven. It's super easy. It's available at most hobby stores, craft stores. When you get it, it's usually a little crumbly. Don't let that freak you out. It's kind of crumbly.
It's like dry or something?
It is a little bit. Okay. You just have to work it for a little while. I've already worked a piece here, so we don't have to sit and just play with the clay for a little while. Once you work a little piece of this clay up,
so you don't need very much, not a very
No, okay. Look at how small these little pieces are.
Wow.
They're just tiny little pieces, and this is how super easy it is to make them.
Okay.
You're gonna squish it between your fingers, right?
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna
Should I be using this one here?
You can,
okay.
Absolutely. Go for it, play with it. Squish it between your fingers here. Make it a cute little pendant shape.
Okay.
We're gonna put a little hole in it with this and kind of wiggle it around so that we can hang it from a necklace.
Okay. I'm gonna start over here while you keep working there.
All right, and then?
I didn't like my pendant shape.
It's gotta be just so. I know how
you are. It wasn't pendant-y enough for me.
Pendant-y?
I just made it up, it's fine.
Once I make the little pendant shape, then you can use your finger, or you can get the little kiddos involved.
Yeah.
So you can make one for grandma or something for Mother's Day is going to be coming up this year, whatever you want.
All right.
And you're just pressing your finger in there, press it nice and hard, kind of hold it for a second, and lift it out. Now you're not going to see much of a fingerprint when you first do it.
Okay.
You're going to think, what, there's no fingerprint on there. There will be. We're going to bake this, and there is going to be a fingerprint on there. Okay, get yourself a little hole in there.
There
perfect. And then set her down.
And just do my
thumbprint
finger.
Thumbprint it?
Thumbprint?
Thumbprint, sure. Whatever works for you.
Is this going to unlock my iPhone later, too?
That's why I'm doing it.
Okay.
All right, so we've got a thumbprint on there. Now, through the magic of television, we're going to bake these at 275 degrees for about 10 minutes. Watch them close.
Oh, not too long
at all. Not too long at all. Once they come out, they're going to look like this.
Is it going to shrink like that, too?
I made this one a little bit smaller.
A little smaller, okay.
Yeah, it just shrinks a teeny bit, but not much. You still can't see much of a fingerprint in there.
So see, it's
but
small.
The trick is this stuff right here.
Okay.
This metallic spray paint.
Oh, some Rust-Oleum. Okay.
You can get it in different metal colors. The trick, though, is to be careful how much you spray on there.
Yeah.
You can see the difference here. I'm going to show you two different ones. One of them I sprayed with a lot of the spray paint.
Can I guess that's that one?
That's that one.
And that one you can really see the...
It definitely looks more metallic, but this one I sprayed a little bit less and you can see the fingerprint a little bit more.
Yeah.
I think I'd like a little something in between these two, but play with it a little bit. Make a couple of extra ones. This stuff is cheap. You only use a little bit of it. So make a couple of extras and play with the spray paint a little
bit.
Just
go ahead and
just
make 10 of them. Just do your whole hand. Both of them.
Absolutely.
Great.
Why not?
Okay. And then should we take this outdoors to spray it? I mean, I know you're not supposed to spray
it's cold out right now.
Yeah.
So what I did is I put these on a little piece of wood. I carried it outside, sprayed it a little bit, walked right back in the house because you don't want to leave this out in the cold.
Perfect.
It's not great for the paint.
Well, you have a rolling pin and other stuff here. Do we need to use these at all?
You can. I bought the rolling pin out because some people, instead of just forming it with your fingers, roll it out smooth. You can even cut heart shapes out of it and put the thumbprint in the corner of the heart.
Oh, that's a cool idea.
I use the tin foil really to bake these things on because they really don't need much support. I suppose you could get one of your pans out too.
A cookie sheet or something like that.
But the tin foil is nice and easy.
Okay.
So it makes it simple to put in the oven and take out.
And how many, is this a bar that comes in there? Because there's probably a whole bunch of that stuff in there. So you could do several different projects with one of these.
I don't think you could make that many little thumbprints. You'd have thousands
of them. A lot of kids there.
But there are tons of other projects you can do with Sculpey. Make little sculptures out of it. Have the kids put together their fun little sculptures and bake them. The directions are on there. You can make big stuff and even bake that in the oven. Just takes a little longer.
All right. Well, Tricia, thank you so much for coming today, for sharing this
project
with us. She's Tricia Szasz from Parkville Artisans Studio over in Parkville, Missouri. Belinda, over to you.